the President of the United States, Harry S. Truman, 32nd person to serve as the American nation's chief executive. A man to whom many millions of people look for guidance. A man whose responsibilities are today as great and whose influence as far-reaching as any other man on earth. On the walls of President Truman's office are portraits of George Washington and Simon Bolivar, which indicate his aims and ideals. The little town of Lamar, Missouri, was Harry S. Truman's birthplace. Here in the rugged farmlands of Midwestern United States, he began the life and career which has taken him so far. On this quiet, small-town street, in a very unpretentious little house which his father had built amid the simple rural surroundings, the future President of the United States was born on May 8, 1884. The nearby, somewhat larger town of Independence became the Truman home when Harry was 7 years old. Here, as a serious-minded country boy, he grew up. Here he went to church, and in the Sunday school he met the 6-year-old little girl who now shares with him the famous White House in the nation's capital as his wife. In Independence, he attended public school and became fired with ambition. In this small-town drugstore, he worked after school on his first job at $3 a week. The big town of Kansas City was not very far away. And while still attending high school, young Harry Truman journeyed here every afternoon for part-time employment on a newspaper, the Kansas City Star. His job was wrapping newspapers, which flowed in what seemed like a constant avalanche from the grinding presses. Not a very exciting position for an ambitious young man, but it paid more than twice as much as the drugstore job. When 17 years old, Harry Truman became a railroad worker, as a timekeeper on the Santa Fe Railroad. This was after he had graduated from high school. And his father had suffered financial reverses which eliminated Harry's chances of going to college and necessitated his going to work full-time and in earnest. But his ambition carried him on, and within less than a year he had gained for himself a position as clerk in a large bank. Then followed 10 strenuous years as a Missouri farmer, and a distinguished service defending the flag of the United States during the First World War. Shortly after being discharged from the Army, Harry Truman and a soldier friend established this clothing store in Kansas City. But along came the National Depression, which caused the business to fail. And it is to the everlasting credit of Harry S. Truman that he slaved for 15 years to pay back every dollar that was owed. His former partner, who still owns the store, and the president are still the best of friends. Today, as through the intervening years during which Harry S. Truman has struggled and risen to his high position in national and world affairs, the big frame house in Independence, Missouri, has continued to be home to him. It is now called the Summer White House, and he returns at every opportunity which his presidential duties permit. Harry S. Truman is fundamentally an average American, not rich, but not poor, not sophisticated, but far from naive, an early riser and a hard worker, and very much a family man. Having lunch with his family on the backyard lawn of his rural summer White House in the little town of Independence is symbolic of the democratic principles which motivate the life of this leader of the people of the United States. The family is equally unpretentious and American. Thank you. To the president, the first lady of the land is known as Bess, the only girl he ever courted, and they are bound by a deep and abiding devotion. Their daughter, Mary Margaret, is their only child. Here, the president is seen with his sister, Mary Truman, and their mother, Mrs. Martha Truman, well past 90 years of age, to whom he is extremely devoted. This grand old lady still lives near the family farm where Harry spent his boyhood, and she taught him the first lessons of being religiously good, economically thrifty, and socially fair and honest, lessons which the president has never forgotten. In spite of the heavy weight of her many years, Mother Truman is surprisingly active. And in spite of the high office to which her son has ascended, she still never loses an opportunity of giving him a mother's advice. Her favorite challenge is, "Be good, Harry." The president has never lost interest in the family farmlands, which he still retains. Of his own earlier years on the farm, the president's mother says, "Harry could plow a furrow straighter than any other boy in the county." It was while Harry Truman was a farmer that his political career began. He became interested in county politics for the betterment of conditions for the common man in his district. His fertile acres are tilled and harvested by his younger brother Vivian and Vivian's son. Many of the fine local roads, as well as public establishments, are the result of Harry Truman's early political efforts. It's a long way from plowing the straightest furrow of any farm boy in his county to the capital of the United States. But Harry Truman came to the national capital as senator from Missouri in 1934, and he brought with him the unpretentious integrity of his Midwestern farm folk and the determination to be economically thrifty and socially fair and honest. The fate of all the civilized nations of the earth hung in the balance at the time of the fourth inauguration of Franklin D. Roosevelt as President of the United States. Harry S. Truman had been one of President Roosevelt's staunchest supporters. He had been elected by a popular vote of the people as Vice President, the man upon whom these greatest of all history's grave responsibilities would fall in case anything should happen to President Roosevelt. No one knew what the future held in store. Little did anyone realize how soon Harry Truman was destined to shoulder the burden of state and carry on to completion the great work which Franklin D. Roosevelt had already come so close to fulfilling. Harry S. Truman takes the oath as Vice President of the United States. Being Vice President of the United States in the most difficult and fateful time in the nation's history established this native Missourian as a national statesman. To fill the place left vacant by the sudden death of Franklin D. Roosevelt, Harry S. Truman became the 32nd President of the United States on the evening of April 12, 1945.